This week on The Wire, banks ease lending criteria, rising market pleases federal government, and home selling at record speed. G'day guys, my name is Tim Guest and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate. We can get all the top stories happening this week in real estate, finance, investment, and more. Our top story for this week, banks ease lending criteria. So leading mortgage brokers say banks are cautiously taking the brakes off home lending and removing extra checks on borrowers that were introduced at the height of the pandemic. Now, the trend comes amid an ongoing surge in new lending, but brokers say they are not seeing a rise in high-risk borrowing, and nor do they believe regulatory caps on home lending will be introduced anytime soon. Several brokers, including Aussie Home Loans and its merger partner Lendi, say banks have become less conservative compared with the height of the pandemic last year. Now, Aussie Chief Executive James Simon says banks had pulled in their horns during the peak of the pandemic, but are now taking a more commercial approach to credit assessments. "We are seeing a more balanced approach by the banks," he says. Lendi says the proportion of loan applications where lenders are requesting more information from the customer has dropped from 48% in March 2020 to 28% this year. And now guys, for our next story, rising markets pleases Fed. So the Fed government is very pleased that high consumer confidence is leading to a strong housing market and remains unconcerned about rising debt levels. Now, the Reserve Bank has warned that optimistic borrowers may lead to a debt blowout. But Assistant Treasurer and Minister of Housing Michael Sukkar says the federal government is pleased the highest confidence levels. Pleased with the high confidence levels, the strength of the economy and the improving unemployment rates are leading to a strong housing market with first home buyers at a 15-year high and owner occupiers dominant. On average, we're looking at affordability being at 20-year highs, which is why first home buyers are at such high levels and why owner occupiers are nearly three quarters of the market, Sukkar says. He says owner-occupiers are in an absolute dominant position because $220 billion has been saved by business and households during the pandemic. A lot of that $220 billion is finding its way into investment in housing, Sukkar says. And now, guys, for our final story of the week. Home selling at record speed. So Australian homes are in short supply and selling at record speeds, with the average number of days that homes are listed for sales hitting record lows in every state in March. According to a housing indicators report by realestate.com.au owner REA Group, dwellings were listed for 48 days on average last month, down from about 60 days in January and 71 days in June last year. Properties sold the fastest in the ACT at just 25 days, falling close behind were New South Wales 27 days and Victoria 28 days. REA Group says average views per listing have also been surging, with every state hitting record highs in March. Naturally, views per listing were up 6.1% over the month and 107% year on year. Now, the report's author, economist Anne Flaherty, says the growth can be attributed to multiple factors, including government support packages for first-home buyers and limited available stock. Flaherty says buyers are searching for more expensive properties than they were a year ago. They're also looking for more space, with inquiries for housing and land surging while demand for units has softened. Well, guys, they're the top stories for this week. Now, please don't forget to like, comment, and share this video, and follow or subscribe wherever you're seeing this. Have a great week, and remember, guys, there is only one thing in life that makes a difference, and that's action. Thanks a lot. Bye for now.